It's so nice to finally meet a Mumbaiker in Manali. So tell us a little about your life in Mumbai. How is it like?
Basically, I'm born and raised in Bombay, and I was working as a hairdresser in Bombay. I was choosing between being a chef and a hairdresser, and I chose hairdressing because it's much easier being a hairdresser as opposed to being a chef. So yeah, I was working there for a couple of years, and living in Andheri, working in town, and that was life in Bombay, busy.
So how did biking start?
Biking always a passion for two wheels. Yeah, right from the time I was a kid, I always had the fanciest cycle and always wanted to ride around. As I grew older, I got a bike. Bike was initially just to commute, and later I started to travel quite a bit with the motorcycle. And traveling and exploring on the motorcycle, it just changes somebody's mindset and the way they think. You can explore a lot more on two wheels as opposed to four wheels, and you can be one with the road and with the nature around you. See, traveling for a week is a holiday. Traveling for a month is an extended holiday. Being from the city, I strongly believe in this one thing. In the city, we're in the city mindset. When we go for a vacation, it takes us, at least me, it takes me a week to get rid of that city skin and get into the vacation skin and or the travel skin. And then you're traveling for another week, and then you're back to the city. So you don't really open up and you don't really feel free. When you're traveling for a long period of time, beyond a month, that's when you actually open up, and that's when you actually start to travel the way one should travel. Yeah.
It's safe to say that this is a bike lover's paradise. Yes. So was it always going to be like this, or it just came out like this?
This was never on the cards. Never in my wildest dreams did I imagine I would land up doing something like this. Some things just happened, and this was one of them. We decided to open a small cafe and boutique accommodation, and as I told you earlier, I wanted to be a chef. And then I trained to be a chef as well, and now I'm running the kitchen over here.
Is there anything you miss about being in Mumbai?
Seafood. We have the best quality trout over here. We do a fantastic trout, but there's only so much trout I can eat. I miss my prawns, I miss my bangdas, my pomfret, it goes on and on.
That is the Goan speaking.
Yeah, I'm raised on seafood. Yeah. Dal rice does not work for me. I'm a proper meat lover.
So any advice for people wanting to move out of the city or looking to settle in the mountains?
It's not all gold, but it's a big risk. You take the risk, you're happy, it works out. It doesn't work out, it doesn't work out. It's if it's meant to be, it will work out. If it's not meant to be, it won't work out. You have to think of one thing: what is your main reason of being getting to the mountains? And why the mountains? Getting out of the city is one thing, getting to the mountains is another thing. So it's about how badly you want it, more than anything else. Don't chase money, don't chase happiness, don't chase anything. Just do what you want to do and everything will follow.
What has changed in you after being in the mountains?
After being in the mountains, life is a lot more peaceful. You get time to enjoy life as opposed to being in the city. It's the same if you work by the coast, or if you're in a smaller place and you're not in a big city. The mountains have a special feeling, special energy. It's something which I can't describe. It's something which you will not understand. You have to come here, experience it, and you'll know what I'm talking about. Well, if you're in Manali, please do come by at Trident. Come by, stay over here if you can. If not, come by for a meal. It'll be our pleasure to host you. And travel, yeah. Travel well. Don't travel for a week. Don't travel for 2 days. Try and club your vacation time and do one long trip as opposed to doing 5 weekend trips. It'll make the world of a difference.